Gravitational lesson is continuing, and we are in the middle of gravitational potential. Previously, we found out the gravitational potential of a point mass, and we understood the meaning of superposition of potentials. That is, how to find out the potential at a point in the field due to many masses. And especially we did find out the potential of many point masses, right? Okay, now we'll continue. We'll find out the potential due to other mass distributions which keep coming in our problem solving very frequently. Okay, now the gravitational potential gravitational potential of a ring of mass. Okay. Do we remember the formula for the gravitational field strength of a ring? Can somebody tell me?
Dmx by x square plus r square to the power 3 by 2.
That's correct. And it has a direction.
Towards
what kind of a direction it has? It is towards the ring. Right. So now our job is to find out how much may be this V here. Okay. Now, let us find out. We have the ring here. And at a distance x from here, we would like to know how much is V. We are also given the mass of the ring and radius of the ring. And the ring has, anyway, uniform mass. Right. So, why did I mention this MRX like this? You should get your potential formula in terms of MRX, for example. All right. So, there are two ways of it. One is the basic method. That is V2 minus V1 equals minus 1, 2, 2. Here, you don't get F. What do you get?
EG.
Yes. EG dot?
DR.
DR, you get. And second method is to find out the potential of a point mass and then integrate for the whole thing. That is using V equals minus G M by R of a point mass. This is what I mean by basic method. In the sense, at infinity we think it is zero, and at x we find out. That's from the first principles. But if I can use this formula of a point mass somewhere, I can directly find out V. Here we already made potential zero at infinity when I did this previously. So the second one is easier. So I'll show you that. Consider a dm element of the mass on the ring, which is at a distance of r from the point considered. So dv What is dv? It is not v2 minus v at infinity minus v at first point. It is the differential element of the potential here. When you found out this v, we already made potential at infinity zero and we got this v. This is only differential element of the potential of dm. That will be minus g dm by r. Luckily, potential is a scalar quantity. And this r is same for all the elements everywhere. Any element you take, the distance is r only. Isn't it so? Tell me. All the elements are at the same distance. So v of the whole ring will be simply minus g dm by r integral. R is constant, like I told you. You can bring it out if you want. So minus g by r integral dm, which is minus g by r into capital M. Integral dm is 0 to capital M, you can say. So minus g m by r. And I've not given you r there, but I've given you r and x here. So I'll write v equals minus g m by r square equals r square plus x square, isn't it? Huh? So root of this one is the formula for potential. So tell me, children. This R is written as this one. I hope you followed what is this dV here. For a point mass m at a distance r, we showed that v equals minus gm by r. So that we applied. But in doing so, remember, we already have taken somewhere potential to be at infinity to be zero there. After that only we got this v. So this is the, it's not the potential difference, it is a potential difference between infinity and v. So there's no need of writing v2 minus v and all that. We simply use this formula of point mass and get it for the whole ring. The second method, which is easier, I have shown you there. And a special case, if you look at x equals 0, v equals v at center is equal to minus gm by r. Very naturally so, because all the point mass are at same distance. So minus gdm by r, minus gdm by r, minus gdm by r, minus gdm by r added will give you simply this one. So tell me, I'm waiting for your feedback. Children, okay, else be like this for long. I mean, I just don't know if you're sitting like that, you want me to continue or what?
Continue.
Like, how should I know that I should continue? No, you people are becoming impossible for me, really. You need to decide as to what to do. It's becoming, I told you, not a very pleasant situation to be in. Because if it is zero feedback and zero response, to whom I should be doing this? At least in the class, I can come and see what you did. Here, I don't know what's happening on the other side. No, that's why the private management, the corporate sector, the trick they do is that just take large numbers and have many branches and give some program. Better students will use it, others will be just not bothered. Now, what is the other method? I told you that is from the definition of potential. The ring you have. At a distance x, what is the potential we set? So you can think potential here is Vx and potential at infinity is zero. As usual, you've got M and R, mass M and radius R. Now, V at infinity minus V at X, or you can write Vx minus V infinity, doesn't matter anything, is equal to minus X to infinity. Eg dot dr. Here dr will be dx basically. X to infinity eg will be this way, dx is that way. So minus eg dx, minus minus going, x to infinity eg gmx by x square plus r square to the power 3 by 2 dx, that is 0 minus vx. And how to integrate this kind of a thing, I already told you, did I?
Yes, sir.
Taking this as t, writing 2x dx equals dt and completing it. You complete this, you'll once again get this only. Vx equals minus gm by root of x square plus r square. This is the basic method. Anytime in future, a new thing comes, we'll go only for that. But I want you to complete this integration because it's already there in the previous derivation somewhere. So if I show it again, you will copy it. Tell me.
Sir, I substituted for x square plus r square is equal to t.
Yes.
And then dx, x dx will be dt by 2.
So this is 2x dx is equal to dt.
Yes, sir.
Not x dx. Huh? Or x dx is dt by 2 if you want.
Yes, sir. That's what I said.
Hmm.
So and then
this will become what? X2, of course, limits also will change, right?
Yes.
Limits will be what? If you want to put the limits, you can put later also.
Yes, sir, I put them later also.
Okay, doesn't matter. Tell me now, what will be
GM
this?
GM I took outside.
Okay.
Then I wrote it as dt by 2 into...
If you want to get 2 there, you can get, no, like, isn't it here? You can divide in this one. So gm by 2, I'll write outside.
Yes.
So
by t power 3 by
2. T power 3 by 2.
Yes, sir. And then minus 3 by 2 plus 1.
All that if you do and put the convert that t into this one and then put the limits, you'll end up with this.
Yes.
Right. So this is actually going to be very important for some other cases, basically. That's why, though it looked easier there, we showed this here also. But what is the use of this potential also, I'll tell you now. We found potential. So immediately we should know why are we doing it. Look at this, a question here. Say there's a massive ring we have. Mass M, radius R we have. And a small point mass here is released. Here we said massive ring because when this is released, this is not going to move. That's why we said massive ring doesn't move. Okay. So find the velocity of M as it passes through the center of the ring. It passes through the center of the ring. Tell me. What do we do? Simply, u1 plus k1 here is equal to u2 plus k2 there. But first of all, the physics of it is what? This E, gravitational field strength, will apply force on it. So it will start pulling it towards this, right? What do you say?
Yes.
As it comes like this, the velocity keeps increasing. Velocity will be maximum here actually. Then, because of that velocity, it goes on the other side. But gravitational force will once again pull it back. So velocity keeps on decreasing until it becomes zero. But once again, the gravitational field strength will be this side. So it will pull it again like this. And it makes oscillations. We did something like this previously, right? For small displacements, we found out that motion is simple harmonic, and also we found out the time period. But right now, I did not mention small or big. Actually, let me put here, this is equal to 2r. So velocity, you might think I'll use v square minus v square equals 2as or anything like that. You cannot, because the gravitational field strength keeps changing with distance. So this u1 plus k1 equals u2 plus k2 is very simple and meaningful. U1 will be potential of this here into mass. That's what you need to do. So potential of the ring at a distance 2r will be how much from the formula? Minus gm by r square plus 4r square, right? R square plus, this is 2r, 4r square, 5r square. Potential of the ring into m, that will give you the potential energy, plus k1 equals 0. U2 at this point will be minus gm by r of the ring into small m of the mass plus half m v square. V is the velocity here, so we'll get for v here. So this is actually what we want. I told you many times, central force motion. So what is happening to some body or few bodies, doesn't matter. How are they moving under their mutual force of gravitation, which is the central force? So the whole lesson is only about that and nothing else. Come on.
Will it be under root 2gm into root 5 minus 1 by root 5 1?
I don't know. I've just given it there. You simplify it. This m gets cancelled. And we should write from that. Now, Aryan and a few others. I'll give you another one. I want you to involve and do it, not sit like this, not sit like some non-participant observers. No, in the first year, you are very communicative, all of you. The reason for this is true, of course. It is it requires some maturity for using online what you call instruction. But at the same time, the subject level has increased, and no follow up, nothing. So that's where you're completely lost. You don't know what is happening there, most of you. That's what I understand. The feedback is gone completely. Okay, I'll now give you another one, and I want you to talk and tell me. We have a disc. Okay, disc means you got mass everywhere, right? And radius of the disc is R, sigma is the mass density. So in terms of sigma and R, at a distance x from here, how much is the potential? So you tell me how to do this. If you talk, I'll talk. If you don't talk, I don't talk. Come on. If it is going wrong, no problem. But when this is given, how do you approach it? How do you start doing it? Come on. You say something, I'll implement it here.
So the field strength will be 2 sigma pi g into 1 minus x by under root x square plus.
Yeah, that means that E will be, Eg will be, tell me what is that?
2 sigma pi g.
It's 1?
Yes, into 1 minus x by under root x square plus r square.
This is the E. So, what would you like to do?
Then we can try it both the methods. First, if we go with the easy one, V is equal.
Which method are you following?
The second one, sir.
Second one means DV, huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. For that, you don't require this, actually.
Yes, sir. But
okay. First in method, second method, what will you do?
We know dv will be minus g dm by r, and here
for a point mass. So how do you apply the point mass business to this disk?
So we know sigma will be m by pi r square.
Sigma equals m by pi r square. Agreed, all that, right? Now, first, before that, this is what actually, when you speak, I'll be knowing the way you are thinking. What's happening, I'll tell you now. Nowadays, understanding has become a very ill-defined concept. Understanding, people think, is familiarity. Like you knew something which was not very stressful on the mind, somehow you were happy with that, you went to the comfort zone. If somebody is speaking, in that speech, in that information, in that discussion, what is familiar to what you understood previously? You're not thinking that it's familiarity, but you are thinking it's understanding. Most of the times it's happening like that. So now when you started saying that this M, this formula I can apply for this, and M equals sigma you told, and then what is DM you're saying?
Sigma
2
pi
r d r. Sigma 2 pi?
R d
r.
2
pi? R. R. D r. What is this actually? Now I understood. I want you to speak. The very first mistake you did was, where is your element?
Yes.
Where is your element? So sigma 2 pi r d r is what? Tell me.
Internal, if we take a section.
What is 2 pi rdr? Where do you see this element? So the mistake was that. You cannot use that of a point mass here. Because on a ring, you could take a point mass like this. But on a disk, where do you take the point mass here? Tell me. Somewhere here?
Like we take a circumference section.
A part of the disk.
actually this trouble will be there forever. After you leave second year also, this setting up integration trouble is going to be there for you if you don't speak. Integration is finding out the area between the curve and the x-axis, for example. So I'll take my element where x plus dx, like this I'll take, no? So here, where will I take my ring element at a distance r, at thickness dr, like this. If you don't do this, that will be meaningless. This is small r, the variable. This r plus dr, the width is dr. So due to this, we know. So dm of a disk will be not point mass m, Shriya.
Yes.
A kind of mixing of things. Some, it looks on the face of it correct, but it is joining things without any proper scheme. That will come out when you do that, when you do mistakes. I'm telling you, only where you start doing things, anything, but especially physics and maths, so problem solving will happen. You start some other way. We'll know about you. What is happening with you, you'll know. But now, until now, it's not happening. Everybody, all are sitting like that and copying whatever it is given. So this is dr. Now dm is, Shriya, sigma 2 pi r dr. So when you said 2 pi r dr, it looks okay, fair. But who's dr? Where is r? This is not correct, isn't it?
Yes, I just remembered that.
So the clarity will come only when you keep doing mistakes like this and keep doing like this. This is lack of, what do you mean by the concept? You are looking at only the algebra. Like whenever things come like this, similar, some kind of what you call vague resemblance to what we did previously, but not actual thing. No, I'll use the formula not for a point mass here. I'll use the formula for a ring. Hello?
Yes.
We cannot use the point mass formula here. We'll use the formula for ring. Do you follow? Probably for something else, I may use the formula for disk if I wanted, if disk is a part of a bigger one. Do you know? The whole integration is that. The area here, the elemental area, representative area was this. So when this is extended from x1 to x2, I'm getting the total area, right? So in a similar way, in any setting up of the integration, you need to take a representative element and expand it so that you get the full object. What do you say? Even now, are you sure they followed?
Yes.
How about others, Aryan?
Yes.
So without first taking that ring, whatever you do will be I told you, no? It is seemingly technical, but actually unscientific. Okay. Now, what will I write? dv equals, tell me, Shriya, you only. Tell me, what should I write now?
G into
minus g
sigma 2 pi small r dr.
dm, let me write dm first. dm.
By r.
Which r?
Smaller.
Just now I told you should use the formula for a ring, that you're not catching it. This r and that r are different. For a ring, r, ring's radius is r, means you get gm by root of
x square minus.
So why did you say minus g dm by r? Where is r here? When you said r, which r you meant?
It should be the in the diagram we drew x square plus small r square.
Formula is known already. So minus g dm. Now you write sigma 2 pi r dr by root over x square plus r square. So v equals minus g sigma 2 pi or pi 2 r dr by root of x square plus r square. Integral. What is the variable here? X or r? What are you?
R is
variable.
Sir, R.
Small r is a variable, right?
Yes.
So what should I do now? Take x square plus r square as
t.
If you know straight away, you can write t. Then x square plus 2r dr equals dt. Am I correct?
Yes. Meaning x square should
be zeros.
Right? Tell me. So yes, minus sir. G 0 to r, this is actually. So what do we get now? This is equal to minus g sigma pi integral 2 r dr is dt.
Dt by root t.
T to the power half. What are the limits? If I put r equals 0, I'll get t equals?
X square.
Right. And then if r equals r, it is x square plus r square. So simplify and tell me, what are you getting? So complete it.
Sir.
I
did not understand. How did we get 2r dr as dt?
Derivative. This is constant 0. R square will be. Look. This is what we did sometime previously. Dr by dt you calculate first.
Yes.
See, this is simple derivative, no? So this dr by dt. You want to write this way, r square equals t minus x square.
Yes.
It will become more complicated if I do that way.
Yes.
R is changing as a function of time, right? So R equals root of t minus x square. R is a function of time. So dr by dt will be what? 1 by 2 root t minus x square into 1. Then look, what is t minus x square? R square. R square under root, so r. All right.
Yes sir.
So what am I getting now? 2r dr equals dt.
Yes. Oh,
no problem. It's better ask than just copying it.
Will it be minus 2g sigma pi under root?
Tell me, I don't remember the formula. I'll tell you. Just a minute. Others?
Yes, sir. Good.
Yes.
Tell me. Aryan?
So minus g sigma pi.
Why minus? You can leave minus, no? If you want. Okay, minus I'll put. Minus g sigma.
Whole under root of x square plus r square minus x.
This one?
Yes.
This one, everybody? It looks all right.
Or we get two.
Two will be there. Two will be there, yes. So if I remove minus here, will x minus that you get?
Yes, sir. Two will be.
You speak. Now I understood. What is happening to you, I'll tell you. This is not bad to be fair to you in the sense, like some kind of a mass is set up, you will pull it. But in physics, to set up the function is actually the challenge. Trishul.
Yes.
No, this is a new phenomenon in the last few years. This is happening. Otherwise, we had all kinds of students, but we really were very happy to have improved each and every student previously. But good thing about them was they were talking. They were ready to do mistakes, and they knew that the way to learn is to do mistakes. Do you know? And they do mistakes, and sometimes people laugh at them, sometimes people criticize them, sometimes people taunt them, sometimes people reprimand them. Many things people do, but they were just doing it. Now what? See, the setting up was becoming difficult. No, you should have agree. You should have agree to it. Yes, our problem is this, and on that we need to do something. Then there is learning, but all this requires what you call is the emotional intelligence. How that comes, I don't know. So this is the potential of a disk. But if you try it this way, you will be in trouble actually. The integration trouble will be there. That infinity limit will be a problem here. You may check it and tell me. Do you understand what I mean by this? In this, we go by the basic definition, isn't it? At infinity, we make 0, 1 of the limits will be infinity. So after integration of this, eg dx, there will be trouble of putting the limit there, for which we need to find out certain methods of integration. Hello?
Yes.
Tell me, children. Is this all right? Now I'll give something else. You need to try. I'm not going to tell you what to do. Okay, I'll do something else here. Discredit, yeah. Now put an most important thing. You need to tell me the gravitational potential of a spherical shell. Of mass m and radius r uniform, of course. We have a shell like this. So mass of that is m r. So at r greater than r, at r equals r, at some point r less than r, at various points you would like to find the potential. What shall we do? Somebody start it, because you're not understanding every time that somebody will start and then you finish. This is actually a very dangerous trend, I tell you. With a teacher who knows things and with students who have not the habit of working, there's the danger is there. Whereas students who are ready to work and teacher is not so good also, because they keep doing the learn things. Do you know? Do you understand what I mean by this? The teacher is not so good, but the students are ready to work. That works sometimes better than the teacher being good and students not being ready to work. Why? The reason is this. It's like poor people trying to come up. Because things are not coming from the teacher, students will struggle to get it. So they do something. But here, teacher is telling everything, so children go to a comfort zone. They think that I'm understanding, I'm enjoying it. It's spoon feeding, like somebody directly putting a sweet in your mouth without even trying to take it and eat. Somebody comes directly and pushes into your mouth and you feel happy about it. So that, no, I'll stop doing that now. Come on. So what do we do? How do we set up threshold? I've already told you the methods. Two methods are there. So which one do you want to apply? That's left to you. Quick, threshold. So you got stuck, no? That means you're only focusing on the algebra. When I'm discussing, I use the word sequential logic. When somebody said something, then after that, how did I get this step from this step, this step from this step, this, that, that's what you're focusing, most of you. In the beginning, I thought your mathematical logic is good, so I could exploit it, I was thinking, but now I'm getting doubts. Which method I should follow now? Can I follow the point mass method?
Second
method, tell me. How do I do, Sai Sudhir?
Sir, here we take a rings.
Ring we take. This kind of a ring. Second method means which second method are you saying?
The point mass.
Point mass method. So for ring you will take, but ring radius will be a variable. Okay, even that have no problem. But easier one for this will be the V2 minus V1 method. V2 minus V1 equals minus 122 EG dot DR. So that's where actually the thing lies. EG is known to us for a shell. And it is a radial symmetry. R, everything is going to be simple. V at infinity will be 0. V at R will be minus 122 gravitational field strength of this. You already forgot that. Gm by r square. And dr is anyway outward along the r equals 0. So minus eg dr you get. So 0 minus vr equals minus minus goes that way. This r to infinity eg dr. So when I'm doing, I don't know whether you're understanding it. That's where my problem is. 0 vr equals r to infinity gm by r square dr. So 0 minus vr equals gm into minus 1 by r from r to infinity. That is gm into minus 1 by infinity minus minus 1 by r. So it is
1 by r.
1 by r. So vr equals minus gm by r. So point mass method is not going to work here. Work, it works. You need to set up enough maths for that. You'll find how that will be difficult. So this comes by how? By starting that and failing, then you'll realize, array, I should not do this. Then you'll come to other methods. So those who are not trying will not improve, believe me. So this is coming like the point mass. The whole thing is coming like a point mass here. That means it looks as if the total mass is concentrated at the center. How many times I use this word? Many times by now. So for the potential also it is like that. For field strength anyway, we thought that for potential it is same as that. That is as if the whole mass was there at the point mass, the total thing. Now at small r equals r, it will be simply put small r equals capital R. Now, tell me what will be inside. Hello. This only will help you. V at infinity minus V at r is equal to minus r to infinity. Eg inside is 0.
Yes.
But one thing, this is not good to do. Because when you're bringing from infinity to this, you'll have crossed two fields. One is field outside, the other is field inside. So you need to integrate differently. E will be different here, E will be different here. Instead, I can take potential here and here. That is V at R. Minus V at R is equal to minus R to R. Inside field is 0. So this will be 0. Whatever you have on the surface will be the potential inside. So this point you will miss because you did not really understand that. Isn't it? You did not try to set up. You did not try to think. So it will go away, Sriya. Do you know? But since I told you already this way, you have to do two times all that. Okay, two times. Okay, all right, I'll remember it. It will not be there in your minds, believe me. I can make it come from you, but who is, no one is talking now in the class. That means they're completely coming unprepared, sitting in the class, copying the things. And that's where the whole problem, like this is such an uncivilized way of doing things, you don't know. Highly uncivilized way. Of course, once again, their better students somehow will manage it. They will later look at something and try to understand, do something. But slowly, if you don't do that, you'll come and turn into mediocrity. Trishul. Did anyone understand? I wrote like this and rubbed it off.
Understood.
What did you understand in that?
Sir, if we take at infinity, we have to cross the
two different fields, no?
Yes, sir.
So that's why. Anyway, I know on the surface. So I'm taking, to make it simple, V at R minus V small r. But you are repeating my words, right? You should have put it like that and made a mistake. Then I'm telling you, just anybody try to do like this, within a week you will be different. That's how learning happens. The other thing is not learning, it is something. Okay, complete it. Of course, if you plot a graph, how does it look? V versus R. If I plot a graph, what kind of a graph I'll get? Tell me, children. Guess.
Sir, a rectangular hyperbola.
Look, potential from center to this is same. So where is the rectangular hyperbola? It will be like this, right? For some time. Huh?
Yes, sir. There will be constant.
And then rectangular hyperbola. Isn't it so?
Yes, sir. Till capital R constant.
Capital R, it is same. Gm by R like that. Isn't it so?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Not really. It is like here. Not there because it's minus Gm by R, right? Hello? What do you say?
Yes, a negative sign will negative. Be this.
This is minus Gm by R. This is also minus Gm by R. But here minus. What do you say?
Yes.
Actually, how I make you learn properly, I'll tell you. The moment you are ready to talk, you're not trying, you don't do mistakes. I'll show you how to do mistakes and learn. That will be a great opportunity. You don't know. It's a real, method of learning is that, believe me. There's nothing like, I told you, that will be okay with students with higher capabilities. Higher capabilities than their ages. That is, in terms of IQ, now I'll talk there. But even they will learn badly if it is only exam orientation and bad method of learning and bad teachers. And they can do really great things if they learn it properly. But that's a separate thing. People don't bother learning all that, which they will know anyway later. I mean, the disadvantage of not learning, they'll know later. But right now, they'll say, I got some seat, he got some seat. But seats also won't happen for the later students if they don't really know how to do things. Now people keep approaching me so many. Every day, one or two people keep approaching me. They say this online, in their college, nothing happened. They did not take care, whatever. Now, can you teach and get IIT in 1 or 2 months? So, this is meaningless. And you have been given so much time, so much freedom to talk. But no, even Basu sir is feeling the same thing. Only thing is, we don't say every time because we'll be finally coming under stress or not do at all, leave it. So if psychological issues come, so we say simply move on. All right, I'll close it now. Attend the session at 7:30 without fail. There I'll talk more. All right.
Yes.
Okay.
Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.